Okay. So now, one of the major questions which is asked by people is like, what is the difference between Lean and Six Sigma? When do we use the Six Sigma methodology and when do you go for Lean? So it is better we understand and do a comparative study of under which circumstances or when do, in which cases we will go for Six Sigma and in which cases we will go for Lean. With respect to any improvement, so the improvement in Six Sigma comes because of reducing the variations. So that's what we have learned in the basics of Six Sigma. That means applying the Six Sigma methodology will reduce the variations in the process, thereby reducing the rejection levels. Whereas the definition of Lean itself is identification and elimination of waste. So the improvement comes because of the reduction of waste through the Lean methodology. Then justification for taking up a Six Sigma project is the reduced rejection rate, that is around only 3.4 defects per million opportunities. Wherever the justification for doing a Lean project is speed, that means the turnaround time is going to, we are going to have a faster turnaround time so that the speed is going to increase. So that is the reason why we take up Lean projects. So the main savings through a Six Sigma project is going to come because of the reduction of cost of poor quality, whereas the savings from Lean projects will come because of reducing the operating cost, like a reduction in inventory cost, improvement in productivity and all those things. So the learning curve is quite long in Six Sigma because the people have to be exposed to a lot of statistical tools and the processes, whereas the learning curve for Lean is very short because these are all mostly common sense approach. So the Lean projects can be implemented at a very with a shorter learning curve. For selecting the Six Sigma projects, there are various approaches are there, whereas for the Lean, the main selection method is a value stream mapping. We will learn shortly about the value stream mapping, what is it. Then the project length is around 4 to 6 months for a Six Sigma project, which is quite a medium term project, whereas the Lean can be done as quickly as within a week's time, and the maximum time taken for completing a Lean project is around 3 months. So we can get quicker results through a Lean project when compared to a Six Sigma project. So the driver for any Six Sigma project is data, because we have seen a Six Sigma is a data driven methodology. Whereas the Lean is a demand driven, that is the demand from the customer drives the Lean initiatives in the company. So the complexity is very high in Six Sigma project, whereas the complexity is moderate in the Lean. So this is actually a one-to-one comparison of when we take up the Six Sigma projects and when we are going to take the Lean projects. Okay, now one of the interesting questions which will be asked is whether Six Sigma and Lean, whether they can coexist in any organization. Okay, because I have seen practically in many companies, the top management it is interested in implementing a lot of best practices. So year by year, they will just say that, okay, this year we want to go for Lean. They will implement a lot of new processes and new initiatives. And the next year, then they will say that, okay, this year I'm going to go for TQM. The next year they will go for, I'm going to go for CMMI. So in that way, every year the top management will be going for new initiatives. So then the employees, sometimes they get fed up saying that, okay, this management is like doing nothing useful. So if an organization, if the management is going to implement both Six Sigma and Lean, then whether that is a good decision. So the answer here is yes, because the Lean and Six Sigma can be applied simultaneously in a Lean Six Sigma project. So normally what happens whenever we are taking an improvement project is, whenever we are taking a Six Sigma project is, as I told you, always there are variabilities in the processes. There are two types of variabilities, that is the special cost variations and the common cost variations. And then whenever we are starting the process, again the process is going to be more inefficient because of the special cost variations. And then these special cost variations can be addressed through the implementation of Lean. So whenever we are starting a improvement project, we start with the implementation of the lean methodology. Then once the process becomes stable and the process is running only under the influence of common cause variation, then we can use the Six Sigma methodology, identify the root causes for all those common cause variations, and then take effective solutions for improvement. So again, when we are coming to the improvement phase, again some of the improvements can take place by using the lean tools like POKIOK, Kanban, 5S, and all those methodologies are there, which will help in achieving a lot of improvement. So that is why we say, whenever we are implementing this Lean Six Sigma, first we start with lean in order to identify and eliminate the special cause variations, so that immediate benefits we get to an extent of around 20 to 30%. Then once the process is stable and running under the influence of only the common cause variations, then we apply Six Sigma, and then to identify the root causes of those common cause variations, and then again during the improve phase, again we apply both the statistical tools of Six Sigma as well as the lean tools for improvement. So lean, Six Sigma, lean. So this is the order in which the improvements will take place. So whenever we want to, there seem to be a lot of waste, whenever we need to improve the workflows, whenever there are human mistakes, whenever we need to minimize the inventories and redundancies, or whenever we need to speed up processes, in those cases we normally go for implementing the lean methodology. So the lean will help us to eliminate the waste, simplify processes, increase speeds, improve workflows, minimize inventories, and mistake proof the processes. But if the organization has got more complex challenges, like there are a lot of quality issues, there is excessive variation in the process, there are complex technical problems challenging the root cause identification, or a lot of numerous technical considerations are there, so in that case it is better we go for Six Sigma methodology. So which methodology we are going to follow will also depend upon what type of problems the company is facing. So again, this slide will give you an idea about what are the different Six Sigma and Lean tools which are going to be used at the various phases of a Six Sigma project, during the define, measure, analyze, improve and control phases. So there are some tools like value stream mapping, then Kaizen events, then visual controls, then pull systems, SMED, 5S. So these are all exclusively lean tools. Then we also have some exclusive Six Sigma tools like ANOVA, DOE, SPC, MSA, etc. And then there are some tools which are common for both, like root cause analysis benchmarking, or communication plans, etc. So these are all some improvement methodologies which are common for both Lean and Six Sigma.